Hi, my name's Emma Smith, and I'm a machine learning engineer for Fetch.ai, and today I'm going to tell you about Fetch.ai's artificial intelligence framework. So this is a system that lets parties work together to train machine learning models whilst maintaining their data privacy and without requiring trust between the participants. So what problems does this solve? So lots of people now, they have big data sets, but often they don't want to reveal the data because it's private or it's valuable. So say it's health data, you don't want to reveal that data and compromise people's privacy. Or maybe it's commercial data, and you don't want to give other companies a commercial advantage. So they've got lots of data, but they don't want to reveal it. They want to maintain their data privacy. And another problem is that training a machine learning model requires a lot of data, which often requires collaboration between the data holders that might not necessarily trust each other. So they can't be certain that the other person's going to act honestly and also try and train this model. So our system solves these two problems because it lets people keep their data privately. So they don't have to share it. It doesn't need to go to some central place and be where other people would be able to see it. And also, because the data doesn't get shared around, you don't need to trust the other people that you're working with as well. And with our framework, you can incentivize other people to contribute helpful updates and disincentivize people from not giving helpful updates for training this machine learning model. Okay, so let's hear a little bit more about the system. So the way this system works, the sort of backbone of this are these hubs. So hubs handle connectivity and they also run apps. So like we see in this picture here, we've got hubs, they're connected together, and hubs have one or more apps running on them. So hubs do connectivity like passing messages around. So from outside the hubs, you can send a message to the hub saying, tell this app to do this thing. An app can say, tell this other app to do something. They can send data between them. And they also, the hubs handle message, they handle process control. So starting up processes, stopping processes. So that's what the hubs provide. They're sort of the backbone of this system. And then the apps are the bits that run machine learning tasks. So apps, they run tasks like training a model or coordinating learning. So you might have an app that's representing a hospital with some data, say about x-rays, and that app would run a model, would train a model so that it learns, say, how to classify x-rays into x-rays that show pneumonia or x-rays that don't show pneumonia. Other apps might be ones that coordinate learning. So an app, you could have an app that tells, say, hospital one, do some training, hospital two, say, provide a score for how good the model is. So that's the kind of task that the apps do. And the apps are quite general. So you also might have an app that's just, its purpose is just to report the scores or say provide graphs and feedback about how training is going. Okay, so that's where we had the hubs, which handle all of the backbone of the system. And then we have apps that are running these tasks. And then what we're using the system for is this training scheme that we call collective learning. So one learner trains a model. And the other ones then vote on this new updated model. And if the vote passes, so if you get more than 50%, then this set of apps that are working together, they all accept the new model. And if you don't get, if the vote doesn't pass, so if it doesn't get enough positive votes, then they don't accept it. And then a different learner is selected to train. So I'm going to show you an example of this in action. For this demo, we've got 5 apps that represent different hospitals, and they're each trying to work on a task which is predicting whether x-rays show pneumonia or whether they're normal x-rays. So there's chest x-rays, and you can see on a chest x-ray whether the lungs have signs of pneumonia or whether they don't. So every hospital has its own independent data set that they don't share with the other hospitals. So there's 5 apps that represent hospitals, and then there's one that's a coordinator. So the coordinator selects who's going to train next. And then handles that voting procedure that I talked about, and then collects the results of the vote and then sends out the new model. And then also we have one more app, so 7 in total, and that's doing making a graph. So that's just reporting the results of how the training procedure is going. Okay, so let's have a look at the demo. So just running an internal here. So here we have, I'm going to start first hub. Okay, so that's running there. And now I'm going to start the second hub. So now we've got two hubs running and they're communicating with each other. And now I've got a Python script. What this is going to do is start up those seven apps that I talked about. So there's five hospitals, each with their own independent set of data. And there's one internal, there's one controller that's coordinating the learning process. And then there's another app that just does reporting. So it's going to produce a graph for us that's showing us how learning is going. Okay, so I'm going to start that there. Okay, so that's going to, so that's going to build. So first it's building all of these apps. And then it's going to send them to the hubs. So they're spread across those two hubs randomly. So the apps can be started on any hub. The hub handles like passing messages around. You give it a name, it can it figures out where the right app is to send that message to. Okay, so it's just launching some apps now. And then once it's launched all of the apps, it's going to send a start message to the coordinator. And then that coordinator is going to start the other ones or tell them all to start responding to messages and then coordinate learning between them. Okay, so we can see here it sent the start message. So now if we have a look at our graphs, we can see how learning is getting on. Okay, so just waiting for the initial results to come in here. Okay, so that's it. So we've got five hospitals here. So along the bottom here, we've got the steps that are taken. So zero is when we start. And we can see everyone starts here with about 50%. So we're doing a binary classification task. So it's just saying, essentially, is it pneumonia? Is it not pneumonia? So if you just check, if you guessed at random, you'd expect to get about 50%. So they all start at about 50%, which isn't very good. And then after one step, they've all got quite a bit better. So this first update that was proposed will have been accepted. So we can see the results of this training procedure. If we look at the votes, probably easy to see there. So what's happening here is this is each step of that training procedure. So we can see for step number one, our five hospitals all voted. Yellow here means a positive vote. Purple is a negative vote. This circle marker denotes which hospital proposed the updates and then whether the one as a whole was accepted or not. So we can see for this one, for step one, it got five positive votes. Hospital three proposed it and overall it was accepted. The second one, we got two positive votes, three negative ones. So overall we didn't accept it. And the system here has actually found quite a good solution quite quickly. So people vote positively if their validation accuracy improves when a new for the new model, so whether they're getting a better or at least as good result with it than they were before. So machine learning problems, usually you have a little bit out called the validation set that's used for this voting. So this is data that hasn't been trained on. So we can see here it actually found a very good model almost straight away. Already got up to quite a high score. Test accuracy, this is the one that really tells you about the performance of the system. So for test accuracy, this is data that's completely never used in training at all. So training data is the stuff that's actually used for training the model. Validation is used for the voting. And then test is something that's just a statistic that's reported. So it isn't data that the system's ever seen. And so our test accuracy is giving us, this is actually like good evidence that the system's doing what we want it to. So they start all at about 50% and then they improve. Got one straggler here. So they've got different randomly selected sets of data. So one is doing worse, but overall it's starting to improve, but shows that the updates, even though some of the weights that it's getting have been trained on other people's data and not its own data, that they're still valuable. Okay, so the system has completed now. So it runs overall for 15 steps. That's a configurable parameter. So working together, they've managed to train a good model and without revealing their data to each other. Okay, so we saw a demo of the task in action. A few next steps, things that we want to add to this system, things that we want to add. So ensuring that the weights don't leak data. So just because you're not sharing the actual data around, even if you're just sharing the weights of a machine learning model, that doesn't necessarily mean that you haven't shared data around. But there's strategies to protect against this. So things like adding noise to the weights obscures the data that they were trained on. Also adding homomorphic encryption. So this is making sure that, so currently the way it's set up is the hub executes the app. So the hub can see the app's source code, it knows what it's executing, and the app has access to the data. So this means the hub also has access to the data. But with homomorphic encryption, you can perform computations on encrypted data. In the previous setup I just mentioned, the hub is able to view the data. So you need to trust the hub. This isn't too much of a flaw because you can have multiple hubs. So one hospital would run its app on a hub that it trusts. But it would be nicer if you didn't have to have everyone having their own hub. Homomorphic encryption would let you do that because it means that you perform these calculations on encrypted data. So your data is encrypted when it's sent to the hub, and you don't need to, so you don't need to worry about them being able to copy it. So that's one thing we want to add to this. Another is making this work for heterogeneous tasks. So that means that everyone's not working on exactly the same task here. So in the demo that I showed you, everyone's working on the same task. They're all trying to classify X-rays into pneumonia or not pneumonia, but they could still share useful updates even if they were working on slightly different tasks. So say one wants to classify X-rays into pneumonia or not pneumonia, and the other one wants to classify the X-rays into for looking for some different condition. From a machine learning perspective, it's probably likely that they can still share the first few layers of their model, which is about extracting features from X-rays. And so we want to provide an example of this. We want to provide a framework that makes this sort of collaboration on related tasks easier. And the last thing that we are aiming to add to the scheme is these incentive schemes. So something where you'll be rewarded for providing good updates or disincentivized for providing bad updates. So we have this voting scheme, which means that the system's robust to anyone who's just trying to give it complete rubbish. So if somebody, say, gives it some random weights or some really bad weights, the rest of the system will vote it down. But you can improve on this by adding an incentive scheme. So people are rewarded for providing good updates and punished for giving bad updates. So yeah, so then you'd have an incentive, even if you didn't care about, you know, what model was being trained. Here we've got the hospitals, they all care about getting a good model. They're all assumed to actually just have an incentive to get a good classification model. But with an incentive scheme, you could have people who don't particularly mind about whether the model is good or not, but they'd still be incentivized to communicate, to share good updates and take part in this system. Okay, so that's a summary of Fetch.ai's artificial intelligence platform.